Guys, welcome back to Vision NLP Core Python Training Part 4. So today's table of content will be we will revise some revise some points which we have done in last lecture. So in last lecture we have seen looping statement. The one was a for loop and other was a while loop. Okay. So we have studied two different ways of using a for loop. Also we have studied how to use for loop in for loop on a list and for loop on a strings also. Also we have seen three basic statements such as break statement, then continue and pass statements in while loop. It was like it will be like an assignment for you guys to use the same continue, break and pass statements into for loop. Okay, and you can submit your tutorial or you can submit your file or the code on group also. Now in today's lecture we are going to see user defined functions. So what is exactly a function? A function is a block of code that performs a specific task. Okay, so that means whatever task we want to do, we can program it and we can repeat it whenever we want, or we can after whenever we call that function, that particular task will get executed once more. Okay, so this is basically the working of a function. So what is exactly user defined function? A user defined function is a programmed routine that has its own set of parameters and it is declared according to the convenience of user, okay, on his own PC. Okay, so there can be a user defined function. We can develop a user defined function and we can program that user defined function in such a way that we whatever code we want to execute after a interval of time or after some particular condition is satisfied, at that time of time, so we can program a user defined function in such a way. Okay, so how to define a user defined function in Python? So in Python, user defined function user defined functions declaration begins with keyword def, okay, and followed by its function name. So after the word def we can give we have to give one space, and then we can have whatever name we want to assign to a variable, okay, not to variable, to a function. Like consider I want to print a hello world. Okay, so I can have a function, I can develop a function which prints this hello world, and I can name that function as print hello world function. Okay, so this is the way of declaring a function. And after the function name, we have to give parentheses, and we can provide arguments. We can pass arguments in that in those parentheses separated by comma. Okay, and after that parenthesis, we have to end that particular line with colon. So this is how we define a user-defined function. Okay, so depending on presence of arguments, that whether we are providing any argument or not, and the return type, that means whether we are returning some value from that function or not. So depending on these situations, there are four types of user defined functions. One is with argument and without without argument and without return. So this is a really basic type of user defined function. There are really less opportunities to use such a or define such a functions that a lot of you will just define such type of function in tutorials only. I don't think there is any real life use case for such a user defined function. So the another type of user defined function is without argument and with return. Okay, so in this type of user defined function, we are not providing any arguments. That means the parenthesis after user defined function will be empty, but we are returning some value from that function. Okay, so this is another type of user defined function. The third type of user defined function is with argument but without any return. Okay, so in this type of user defined function, we are providing values to to that function. That means after the parenthesis, after user defined function, we have to define parenthesis, and in those parentheses we are providing some arguments. Okay, so we are actually supplying some values externally to that particular function. So arguments means we are supplying some values to that function externally, or whenever we are going to call that. So this is really useful type of user defined function. Basically user defined function of type 3 and type 4 are mostly used. Okay, but in type 3 we are not returning anything. That means we can just print something, or we can store values to a list, but we don't return anything, or we return and we are just storing that list. So such a type of arguments can be done, such type of operations can be done in third type of user defined function, like with argument and without return. And fourth type of user defined function is with argument and with return. So this means we are passing values externally to that function, and also we are getting some output from that function. Okay, so consider we have a function named sum. So in that sum function we are passing a list, or a list of numbers, and that function is returning the count of, or the addition of, all those numbers which are stored into a list. Okay, so this is the type of function, this type of function follows in fourth type. Okay, so it can, I want to do printing statement, and I want one now to whenever this print repeat, I want to now whenever I want in such a scenario we can develop a which does this particular again function. We ask numbers and particular condition is got set. I want to repeat this task whenever some satisfied. Then in such a scenario we will use we have to define a function and call that function when particular and whenever that particular statement is true. Simple. Okay, this is the definition of a function. So what is this you define the function. Okay, so in Python build functions that means a library is installs different functions which are provided by a particular library session. So basically this will after provided in or after no on the 6th inbuilt the functions from that library and how to use the another is examples in Python defined function, user defined the function. So what is the programmed routine the user that has set by user according to his or that function which has like a function user wants to do or whatever you develop that type of particular function then can be. So how function called as a user defined function. How to define a function in Python? Basically there is a way to define, there is a way means that standard
function in Python and occur in if we way, then that can into a declaration of proper function. Starts with df keyword. In Python, start okay. Df word. This def key by one space over there. And followed. Right. Then we have to keep one there, like how we do a loop or in while or statements. That type of space or function name we want to develop. Okay. So that can be like if I want to function named mean, then my function name, this is. Parenthesis in then parenthesis we have to keep colon in after parenthesis we can provide arguments like there can be arguments or then there may not be arguments like if I wanted to have give some particular argument then I can keep some arguments and if I don't want to keep any argument then that is also fine also the way of defining a function okay. So or it may not have any return value so this is these are the criteria of defining a function or these are some particular parts type user defined functions so based on presence of arguments whether an argument is present or not and if there is any return from that for that particular user function on so based on these types so one is not return another second type but it is returning something okay so third type is a function which is having arguments but it is not returning anything means we are doing like printing statement into that function or some any other function any other task which is just a we can set it as reminder order into that function is not so that type of function is without return type okay and the fourth type is with arguments return okay. So arguments provided to that function it is returning some value also so this is so these are user defined functions so we are going to see one by one find a function so we will see the first category without any return so here I will I told you user defined function so this keyword def this space then this is my function name so this the function hello world okay and what this function is printing so find the word I have and I will okay this function and is to call this function so how to call a function which is not and which is not returning any value so for that we have any argument to give the function name whatever the function name is so and we have this open parenthesis and we have to just run this so what this function is doing just simple thing just print hello world okay so this is calling a function in Python I had arguments then I need to queue these parentheses so come later on and a which will be good. So for that I'll write yes. Then what I do that particular can be and I'm not providing keep this parameter empty I wanted to okay I will so for that I will use and in one is good okay So this is my user defined set function named this is how I declared print py, and now I wanted to call that function. So for calling that particular this command, I can print, I have to write print and then parenthesis. So this will say that Python is good. Okay, a basic really basic type of now today the another function was the arguments, the user defined function is returning some value or returning something. Okay, so this is one function, the many arguments. Okay, so basically the name is mean and it is not accepting any. This mean function will do value. It will calculate arithmetic mean of provided or whatever values that are in this parenthesis, whatever value provided. Okay, so basically the formula for consider if we have values some 10 numbers, arithmetic mean is like the, and we have to calculate the arithmetic mean of 10, so that will be sum x. So sum x I will be the number. So the sum is and divided by total number of so, write a function. I have a function. Okay, I'm generating mean of just whatever value numbers 10 and 15. Okay, and so for that what we have calculated that we want over here. Okay, so let us define this and here arithmetic number. Now I want and use as this is the method, like same method as mean and then parenthesis. So this has provided me arithmetic mean of and 15. Okay, so now let us define a user function. We return us at 200. For that we have to be then space, then I would like to edit. Now we are in, you know, that we want a particular particular command to happen. Okay, so our values are not going to change in this, so that's why we are not giving any arguments. After that I will write h add 20 plus 1 to return whatever outcome of this particular command is. So for that I will write, I will use this return add. Okay, now our function. Okay, so for calling this, just a minute, calling this function we use addition, return us the add. Okay, so this is printing the value of add. We can also store whatever value no matter value has returned into a new variable. Okay, like now I can use a variable add to numbers. I am storing what variable numbers, and now I want to return. So for that I can use just to numbers command. Okay, so accessing are returned by a party. My first function was returning just only one value and I return. So see, I have given only one parameter over here, which is subtract numbers. And we wanted to access all addition as well as the subtraction of those. I will not give any arguments. I am adding 15 and 20 equal to 20 minus 15 returns and comma. Okay. So of user defined function, when I want to return two values, we can add these two variables using comma separated. Okay, and now I wanted to extract these two values. So for that I will use over here add number and subtraction of numbers, and I will call this function. Okay, so for calling this function I will use the previous command, addition and subtraction, and I can the values which have got returned, these are stored into this add number and subtract number variables which I defined over here. So for printing those values we need to call this function, we need to use print statement. Okay, so for that okay, so this has thrown a error, like a name error. So what does this name error actually means? This error means that whatever whatever I have written over here, it is not defined previously. Okay, so for that whenever such a type of error comes or occurs, I have to make sure that I am writing exactly the same name what I have written over here, okay, or yeah, written over here, or I have defined it previously, okay. So when I replace yes from this, the error has disappeared and it has printed exactly the same values, okay. So this is like a second type. So we will move on to third type of user defined function. The third type is with arguments but without any return, okay. So now in this type of user defined function, we are providing some arguments but we are not getting any output from that particular program, okay. So when such type of situation, we can use such type of user defined function, like if I wanted to have a reminder, okay, then at particular time and location, like I have done one code and I am keeping that code on running, and consider that code will take like 5 hours of whole training time or running time, and I wanted to have a reminder at particular one hour, okay. So in such scenarios we can use such a type of statement, okay. Now the values which will be returned by that particular statement will be like whatever seconds that has collapsed between previous print statement and now, and it will print that statement, okay. So this is one another example. So coding for that example, I will teach you how to code for such examples also, but not in today's lecture. So now here I have defined a function called mean, okay. So I wanted to get mean of two numbers, and these two numbers I have not defined previously, okay. So basically I can change these numbers anyway or where whenever I want, okay. Like I can have means printed off on list, okay, like whatever values that are stored into a list, whatever integer values that are stored into list or numeric values, I want to have a moving average of that list. So in such scenarios we can define a mean function, okay. So now I have defined this mean function, and which is accepting two numbers. The numbers can be integers as well as floats. So first number is these are the two arguments of this mean function. Now I wanted to get arithmetic mean of these two numbers. For that I have used the same formula which I told you before, like number one plus the summation of these two numbers divided by two will be the arithmetic mean of these two numbers, and then I am printing this arithmetic mean, okay. So now I wanted to know what is arithmetic mean. I want arithmetic. So for that I have commented this string, or I just transferred this variable into a string using these quotes, and then I wanted to print the arithmetic mean. I used this arithmetic mean after print statement, okay. So this is our first user defined function with arguments and without return. And now I wanted to call this particular function, okay. So while calling this function, we have to make sure that we are providing the arguments, okay. Now if I don't provide arguments and just call this function, then it will throw an error. The error name will be type error and mean missing two required positional arguments, number one and number two, okay. So what does this particular error means? That we are missing arguments. So it is clearly written over here. So you have to make sure that you read a particular argument, particular error. I wanted to get mean value of this 10 and 20. So my arithmetic mean of 20 is function on a hello guys on a list, and we are going to try to extract moving averages of this list. Okay, so in the last lecture I have told you how to define a list using for loop. Okay, so this is the smarter way of defining a list. So what I have done, like I have stored values from 0 to 15 and in a sequence. Okay, so the sequence will be like 0 1 to 1 to 14, and I have stored all these values into LST. Just a minute. Yes. So we have defined a list over here, and we are going to have moving average of on that list. Okay, so what exactly moving average means? Okay, so we are going to calculate average of consecutive two numbers. Okay, so the first number will be 0 and the second number will be 1. So in next iteration, the moving average, the first number will be 1 and second number will be 2. In third iteration, the first number will be 2 and the second number will be 3. Okay, such averages are called moving averages. So this particular term comes from time series analysis, and it is useful over there. So we have defined a list over here. And now I will show you how to calculate moving average of a particular list. Okay, and now I have used this for statement, like for I in range length of LST. Okay, so the length of LST will be 15 because we have defined taken range of 15. So length of list, our list will be 15, and I am doing minus 1 because when we are doing moving average type situations, then we are going to calculate a moving average for 14 times, not 15 times, because we are taking moving average of two numbers. Okay, that's why. So now I will store one number as number 1 equal to LST I. So for first iteration, value of I will be 0. So I am extracting whatever number has stored at the first zeroth location, zeroth index position in this particular list. Okay, so the first number will be for first iteration, the number 1 will be 0 and number 2 will be 1. Okay, and its mean moving average or mean value will be number 1 plus for calculating the mean, we have called the mean function which I have defined over here. Okay, so the first number will be 0 and the another number will be 1. So arithmetic mean will be 0 plus 1 divided by 2. That means 0.5. okay, and we are printing this arithmetic mean. So I am calling this mean function, the above mean function. So on to second iteration, the first number will be 1 and the second number will be 2. So the summation of these two numbers will be 3, and the mean number which will be going to print is will be 1.5. okay, so here we can see the arithmetic mean of or moving average of this particular list. Okay, so arithmetic mean of first two numbers is 0.5, arithmetic mean of second two is 1.5, and arithmetic mean of last number is 13.5. okay, so this is how we can call a function inside a for loop. Okay, now if I consider, if I want to print a string iteratively, and I know print whatever values I am passing to passing as an argument to this particular function, I wanted to print these particular values. So so this is one simple basic format. This function is having arguments, but it is not returning anything. And now I will define this function, and I want to develop one more list. That list says hello world, how are you. Okay, and now I want to print each and every item from this list iteratively, but using this particular function. So for that we can use like for loop, like for I in LST. So values of I will be, for first iteration value of I will be hello, for second iteration it will be world, and for third it will be how. Okay, so So variable I will take one by one values which are stored in this LSD1 list, and it will the value of I will be passed as an argument to this print string function. Okay, and it will print whatever value of I is. Okay, so this is how we can print values of I or a particular list. Okay, so now consider I wanted to provide a list, whole and soul, that I don't want to get any moving average of that list or anything else, but I wanted to know the mean of all values that are stored into that mean into that list. Okay, but in such scenarios we have to make sure that the list is having one only single data type, and that data type should be in should be numeric. Okay, that can be float or that can be an integer, but that should not be there should not be any value string type. Okay, so here I have defined a new function named mean, and it is having a list as an input. Okay, now I have to make sure that I have to add values one by one which are from which are stored and into that list. So for that we have to make sure that our previous we have to define one define a variable which is, or this is like initializing a variable, and in initialization we have provide stored value zero, assigned value zero to that variable. Okay, now for first iteration the value of I will be whatever value stored at zeroth index position, and I will add that value into this addition. In second iteration the value will be stored at one index position and it will be added into this. Okay, so basically this will sum these three lines will sum values will return us the summation of values that are stored into that particular list. Okay, now I will print this addition, or print whatever addition I have found. Okay, so for printing I will use this print command. Now I will calculate arithmetic mean of all these numbers. So for calculating arithmetic mean we can we have the addition of how many numbers are addition of all these numbers that are stored into that list in the addition variable, and we have to know the formula is a summation xi divided by n. Okay, so n is number of elements that are stored into that particular list. Okay, so for that we have to use this len function. So len function will provide us the number of elements that are stored into this into this list. Okay, and now I will print the arithmetic mean of all mean of the list. Okay, now this is my declaration of a function, and now I will define a list, I will define a list of 50 numbers, 50 numbers that are sequentially stored from like 10 to 50, and this is a list of numbers which are from 10 to 50. Here we can print it and we can see the numbers are from 10 to up to 49. Okay, now I wanted to get the mean value of that particular list. Okay, whatever we defined. So when I call this function, in main function we have to provide a list over here. Now when I call this function we can see that addition of all these numbers which are from 10 to 15, 10 to 49 is 1180, and arithmetic mean of all these numbers is 29.5. okay, so this is how we can get arithmetic mean of numbers. Now we will define a function which uses inbuilt function sum. So basically in previous function we used these three lines of code for addition of that particular list. Now we will define a function which you we will use an inbuilt function to extract a summation or addition of the list. Okay, and define a new function. So I will define a new function using keyword def then mean mean. Now LST as a least. So now we can use this sum function for addition, sum of least. Now the sum of least will provide us the summation of all the numbers present in this list. So I will show you what is the output of sum of least ones. Okay, so the sum will be 1180, which is already here. Now we have to store this value in some we have to assign this assign value returned by this function to some variable. Okay, so I will write the name of that variable as addition. Addition equal to, and I will print this addition using print addition. Also, I will get the for getting arithmetic mean, we have to define a new variable like arithmetic mean, arithmetic mean equal to arithmetic mean will be addition divided by the number of elements that are present into that list. Okay, so whatever addition we have got, that is stored into addition variable and divided by length of that LST variable. Okay, sorry, length of LST. So the here it will be stored length of arithmetic mean of the this particular list, and I wanted to print this arithmetic mean also. Print okay, so this is one another way of defining the same function we have defined over here. And now I will call that function mean LST, and I will provide the same list which I have defined over here. Okay, so though it will show you that the values are same. Okay, so this is like, this is using an inbuilt sum function. This I did this whole coding for to show you that how we can use an inbuilt function sum. Okay, so this is another way of defining a function. Now we will move on to fourth type of user defined function, which is with arguments and with return. Okay, so this type, in this this type of a user defined function, we have to provide arguments also, and we have to return something, return whatever the operation is done, and we have to return some value also. Okay, so here I have defined some the same example like mean, and mean of first number and second number, and we are calculating the mean using this formula. Arithmetic mean is equal to summation of these two numbers divided by the number of divided by 2, and I am returning this this variable. Okay, so this is my basic example, and now we can get this arithmetic mean using I wanted to get a mean of two numbers, that is 20 and 50, and this can be done using and I will call this function mean 2050, and whatever value it has returned, I will store that value in arith mean name, by the way, variable name arith mean, and I will print this statement. So arithmetic mean of 20 and 15 is 35. Okay, so now we will define a user defined function which returns only odd numbers. It will not return any even number. Okay, and we will provide a list which is from range from 0 to 15 on 15. Okay, so for that we will define a function using def statement. Def, I wanted to get only odd numbers, so I will write name as odd numbers, and I will give you as an argument, I will press a list. Okay, I will give a list. Okay, so I will write the list name over here. The list name is LST. Now to get list, to get only the odd numbers, we have to make sure that we store the odd numbers in at some place. Okay, so for that I will define one list odd least. So this is a list. This is initialization of a new list. Now we will we have to do all these things iteratively. So for doing doing such a thing iteratively, we have to make sure we can use for statement, like for I in LST. So whatever values that are stored into LST, that will be taken by this variable I sequentially. Okay. Now I have to check whether that value of I is divisible by some number or not. So for that we will make sure, like, consider I is equal to 5 divided by 2 is equal to, here we can see, and if I press double, it's a little bit tough to get exactly the all numbers. So to get exact division, or to get whatever remainder remainder is remaining after division happens, so for that we can use this modulo sign, and it will tell us what is if there is any number remaining. Okay, so for that I have used this modulo sign. Like if I do this 4 modulo 2, it will return us 0. Okay, so now we will use this particular modulo function in our odd list function, whatever we are going to define. Okay, so now I will check whether if that I modulo 2 equal to 0, then we know that, or then we know that the number is even. Okay, so I will write this pass statement. If this particular condition is not satisfied, then we will add that number, whatever number I is, in the odd list. Okay, so odd list dot append. I. Okay, so this particular for loop will iterate on, consider for first iteration it will have value 1. Okay, now I will define a list over here, list above, like LST 1 equal to I for I in range 10 to 20. Okay, so our list is, the values of list list will be 10, 11, 12 and up to 19, and I wanted to get only odd numbers from this list, and for that I have defined this function. Now for first iteration, the value of I will be 10, so it will check whether I modulo 10 equal to 0. So the so it will show us that this command is true, and that will that's why it will move on to second iteration. Now the value of I will be 11, and it will again check whether whether this I modulo 2 equal to 0. So in this particular situation, 11 modulo 2 will have remainder 1, and that's why the value will be this condition will be false, and it will enter into else statement, and it will add a value of I which is into that odd list. Okay, so also we will print this value of I. Okay, odd number equal to I, and now this function will continue up to the it iterates up to value 19, and now we want to return whatever odd numbers we have found. Okay, so for that we will use return statement, return odd list. Okay, so this is our basic user defined function to get only odd numbers. Now I will call this function. So for calling this function, I have to make sure I provide a list. Okay, So whatever value I'm going to have as a return, I have to store that value or store that value in a variable. So for that, I will write a new variable name like odd numbers list. And I will call this function odd numbers. And we wanted to find odd numbers from this particular list, that list one. So for that, we will provide as an argument list one. Okay, so whatever numbers, whatever return will be, if we wanted to print, we can use print statement, or we can directly write odd numbers list. And if I enter here, we can see that there are like odd numbers 11, 13, 15. And we have also written a list over here. Okay, so basically this whatever previous to out function, that is output of this, that is the printing done into this function. And whatever is written after this out function, that is the numbers. Okay, so this is how we can define a user defined function to get odd numbers. Okay, so guys, I will stop over here. So this is all about user defined functions. Like you should try to build a user defined function for getting prime numbers, and try to deliver that code on the group. Okay, I will judge that code. I will test that code. If that code is good, then good. If that code is not good, or if that code is will not be working, then I will show you how to get user how to get prime numbers. Okay. So this is all about today, and in tomorrow's session we are going to see object oriented programming. Okay, and that's all for today, and I will stop this meeting. Okay, so thank you for attending. If you have any queries, please make sure that you should comment on the group. Okay, so thank you guys. So in tomorrow's video.